Hello, welcome back. In this lecture, I will be discussing about dead time of the GM counter. After every pulse, the GM tube becomes temporarily insensitive to count the next pulse. And this time duration is referred to as dead time of GM counter. And the typical value of this dead time for various types of GM tubes ranges from 100 microseconds to 500 microseconds. Consequently, the pulses that occurs during this time are not counted. Whenever a charged particle like beta particle or an ionizing radiation like gamma radiation enters GM tube, you will see that there will be ionization process. That means you get negatively charged particles, that is electrons, and you get positive ions. By mass, if you consider, the ions will have heavy mass, positive ions will have heavy mass, and they have to migrate from anode region to cathode region. And because of the heavy mass, they move slowly towards the cathode. And the presence of these positive ions around anode lowers the electric field. Sometimes it brings down below the Geiger threshold. If the voltage is below the Geiger threshold, then the GM counter becomes insensitive. It will not count. So we have to wait till there is re-establishment of this threshold voltage. This time duration during which there is decrease in threshold voltage to the development of threshold voltage requires certain amount of time during which your counter will not detect any radiation, or in other words, it becomes temporarily insensitive, and this time duration is referred to as dead time of the GM counter. And this is very important to in GM counter. One has to measure this to understand the sensitivity of the GM counter or the GM tube. If the dead time of the GM tube is less, then you can say that it is more sensitive, and vice versa. Suppose we take N as the actual count rate and M is the measured or the observed count rate, then the error in counting will be equal to N minus M. And if the GM counter or GM counting system, if it is unable to respond to the particles for a time interval T seconds or tau seconds, then the number of missed particles or missed count rate will be equal to NMT. And that should be equal to N minus M. And this will lead to a following relation: NM tau is equal to N minus M, or in other words, N is equal to M by 1 minus M tau. In this experiment, we use a method called as two source method to determine the dead time of the GM counter. There are various other methods available in the literature to measure the dead time of the GM counter, but here we discuss about two source method. One can also measure dead time of the GM counter by using a single source, but here we use two source method, which is relatively simpler compared to any other methods. In this method, what we do is we measure the counts by using two identical sources, either beta or gamma sources, one after the other, and also using them simultaneously. What we do is we place the source 1 first, we take the count, we place the second source, we take the count, and we place both the sources together and we measure the counts. But here care has to be taken about the relative positions of source 1 and 2 with respect to the detector. We'll come to that very soon. And this is the formula that is used to determine the dead time of the GM counter, where tau refers to dead time. M1 is the count rate with only source 1, and M2 is the count rate with source 2, and M12 is the count rate when we use both the sources together. And this MB refers to the background count. This is the background count. This one is the background count, and generally this tau is expressed in terms of this units, that is microseconds. And this is the procedure that we use. First, we have to set the GM counter for operating voltage. For this, you should know the characteristics of the GM counter, and the value of this operating voltage differ from different counting tubes, GM tubes. One has to carry out an experiment to know these operating voltage, and after knowing this operating voltage, you have to set this GM counter for that specified operating voltage, and you have to set the time up to which you want to measure the count rate. Here actually we set this for 5 minutes. More the time that you set, better will be the accuracy. So we set it for 5 minutes, that is about 300 seconds. Then you have to measure the background counts without keeping any source. You have to measure the background counts, because from cosmos, from the environment also, we will be getting certain counts. You have to eliminate this count, you have to minus this from the actual count. For that, you have to measure the background counts. This is measured 4 times, 2 times before placing the source and 2 times after removal of the source. MB1 and MB2 refers to the background counts before placing the source, and MB3 and MB4 refers to the counts, background counts, after removal of the source. One can calculate the average background count by taking the average of this MB1 plus MB2 plus MB3 plus MB4 divided by 4. That gives the average background counts per second. Then you have to keep the first source in the source position. There will be a source holder to keep both the sources. You should be very careful in placing these sources. You have to place the first source in the first position of the source holder. Then you have to take the counts in different trials for 5 minutes each, and you have to take the average counts, and finally you have to take the count rate, that means counts per second, average counts per second. Similarly, you have to place the second source in the source holder along with the first source. This gives you the count when both the sources are present. That is why this is referred to as M12, because both the sources are present. And again, you have to take the counts for 5 minutes each in different trials, and you have to take the average. In the next stage, you have to remove the first source, so that in the source holder there will be only the second source. And again, you have to measure the counts in different trials, and you finally have to take the average count rate. Once if you know M1, that is the count rate for source 1, M12 when both the sources are present, and M2, that is when only the second source is present, and if you know the average background count, then by using the formula, this formula, you can measure the dead time. Tau is equal to M1 plus M2 minus M12 minus MB divided by 2 into M1 minus MB into M2 minus MB. This will be in microseconds. These are the observations and calculations. See, first we measure the background counts MB in two sets, in two different trials, MB1 and MB2, these two before placing the source, and MB3 and MB4 after the removal of the source. And the average will be MB divided by 300 seconds. That gives you average background count. Then you have to place the first source in the first position. This is carried out at two positions. This is for the first position in the source holder. We keep source 1, we take counts for 5 minutes in 3 different trials, trial 1, trial 2, trial 3, and we take average, and we designate it as M1, and we take the count rate, that is counts per second, that is this m1 divided by 300. Then we place the second source together with the first source. We take the counts in three different trials and we call it as m12, and we take calculate the count rate, that is m12 divided by 300, that is this one. And we remove the first source now, and in the source holder there will be only the second source, and for which again we repeat the same procedure and we measure m2 and the count rate. Once if you know m1, m12, m2 and mb, using the previous formula you can calculate the dead time. Similarly, one can do this same procedure, you can repeat the same procedure by keeping these sources at some other position, some other definite position from the detector, that is at second position, and it is repeated and you can calculate the value and you can record it. This is actually the panel of, this is the GM counting system. This is Nucleonics make GM counting system. Let me tell you about some of the important knobs here. This is the knob that is used to set the operating voltage. Before switching on this, you have to keep this at minimum position. By varying this, you can increase the voltage, and this voltage here, it will vary. And this is the program button by which you can set the preset time, etc., and you can store it. And this is to start the counting, and this is to end the counting. And this upper and lower arrows are used to set the time and various other parameters. This is the power button to switch on as well as switch off this. This is the panel of GM counting system. This is Nucleonics make, and for different GM counting system, now the panel will be different. Okay, here we demonstrate how to take the background counts using the GM counter and also how to do the preliminary adjustments. First thing is, you should know this panel. As I already mentioned, you have various knobs and buttons to set the voltage, time, etc., and this is the one to set the voltage. What you have to do is, before switching on this counting system, before pressing this power button on, you have to ensure that this is at minimum position. For that, you rotate this counterclockwise and ensure that this is at minimum position. Otherwise, if it is at high voltage and if you press this button, there is a chance that since high voltage enters all of a sudden, there is a possibility that you may spoil the counting tube, GM tube. That is why this is very important. See that this is at minimum position, rotate it counterclockwise completely, and then switch on the power button. We will demonstrate how to set this. You ensure that this is at zero, then switch on this power button and wait for this display. It will display the making, etc. This is program button, press it, you will find preset time. Initially it is actually adjusted for 300 volts, 300 seconds. You can change it if you want. So for that you can use this lower arrow. Now you can see that I will change it for 60 seconds. You can shift the decimal. Now this you can make 0. Now it is set for 60 seconds and you can store it afterwards. And this button can be used to vary the voltage. You can see that the voltage varies. You have to set this voltage for the operating voltage, and that depends on the GM tube. And for this Nucleonics, for this particular GM tube, the operating voltage is around 330 volts. You have to vary this gradually, don't increase it at faster rate, vary this slowly, and you set it for 430 volts. For this operating voltage is 430 volts, you set it for 430 volts, it is set for 430 volt, and if there is small fluctuation, one or two volts, you don't worry. Then you can start this, press this start button. When you start this button, you can notice here, this shows the time elapsed, 8 seconds, 9 seconds, etc. And this is the preset time. I have set it for 60 seconds here for demonstration purpose. But actually, to find out the dead time of the counter, usually we set it for 300 seconds. And only for demonstration, I am just set it, I have set it for 60 seconds. And I have not kept any source in the source holder. That means we are measuring only the counts from the background. So this is to measure the background counts. After 60 seconds, you don't have to stop this, it will automatically stop. But if you have set the preset time for larger time and if you want to stop it in between, then you can press this stop button. Otherwise, it is not necessary. After 60 seconds, since it is set for 60 seconds, after 60 seconds, it will automatically stop. And this gives you the count. See, for 60 seconds, we are getting 32 counts. That is the background count. This background count, you have to measure 4 times, 2 times before placing the source and 2 times after source measuring, after removal of the source. Okay, this is the holder, source holder, and this is actually handmade source holder to keep 2 sources. You can notice that there are 2 positions here and we have kept a source here. This is the radioactive source that we used. This is for source 1 and this place is for source 2. And what we do is, we place the source in the first place and we will keep it near the GM tube at a particular distance. We have used, we have placed it in the third groove here, you can notice. And now already voltage is set, time is set, you just press the start button and you have to wait for 300 seconds. But for demonstration, as I said, we have set it for 60 seconds. For 60 seconds, it will count. You can notice that now the count is varying at the faster rate. In the previous case, we were just measuring the background counts, so it was very slow because from the background we are getting, we usually get very less radiation. But here we have kept the source, we are getting, depending on the strength of the source, we get counts here. You have to wait for 60 seconds, but to measure the dead time, remember you have to do it for 300 seconds. After you have to wait for 60 seconds. After 60 seconds, automatically it will stop. You don't have to press the stop button. Then it will show the counts for 60 seconds. You can notice that it is about 1311 counts. Okay, to measure M1, we placed the first source at the first position and we placed at a definite distance from the detector. Now to measure M12, what you have to do is, you have to place another identical source in the second position and you have to place these two together at the same distance from the detector. Just like this, place it, and now you place it in the source holder. At exact, we placed it in the third groove, now also it is placed in the third groove. And you start it now. Now you can notice that the count varies at the faster rate because the counter is measuring the counts from both the sources. Hence, it is varying at the faster rate. You have to wait till 300 seconds. But as I said, for demonstration, I have just kept it for 60 seconds. It will measure the counts up to 60 seconds. To wait for 60 seconds. And as I said, you don't have to press the stop button. After 60 seconds, it will automatically stop. Once again, you can ensure that this is the voltage set. The operating voltage is about 430 volts. Again, don't worry about this one or two volts fluctuation. And this is the preset time. We have set it for 60 seconds. And after 60 seconds, this will automatically stop. Now you can notice that for 60 seconds, it is 2179. The count is more. And don't press touch this knob or switch off this button. Let it be like that. And what you to do next is remove the source 1 and repeat the same procedure. When you do that, you will be detecting the counts from only second source. That means you get M2 value. Once if you know M1, M2, M12 and MB, using the formula that we have mentioned earlier, you can calculate the dead time. See, after taking readings, there is an important procedure that you have to remember. This GM counter is very costly, particularly the GM tube is very costly. To safeguard your GM counter and the GM tube, you should not switch off this all of a sudden. What you have to do is, you just rotate this knob in the counterclockwise direction gradually and make the voltage 0 before turning off this. You vary this slowly. Thanks for watching. Thank you.